here. I am so glad you could join me. You know what? As per requested, I am going to do a video on and about my monthly meetings with all of my girlfriends, how we get together and we have these big slumber parties, okay? So I'm going to have to tell you guys all about it. Y'all have asked me to talk about this over and over again. I'm just now getting to it. Thank you, girlfriends, okay? So thank you, darlings. I appreciate very much. For those of you that are new to my channel today, I invite you to scroll on down and hit that subscribe button. Listen, you'll become a member of my tribe. We just love to have another girl with us. Yes, we do. And see that little bell? Go ahead and click that bell. It'll be notifying you of my upcoming videos. I generally film twice a week, sometimes three. Okay, so today we're going to talk about my monthly slumber parties with all of my girlfriends. There is a group of us. There is about 10 that were really tight. And we get together once a month and one night a month, usually on a Saturday night, if we don't already have other plans, because we all have a set schedule on doing this usually. And we get together and we have a big slumber party. Now, let me tell you what I mean by a slumber party, what we do. First thing, everybody brings a dish of some sort. It could be crudite. We like our hummus and our carrot sticks. We like our big fruit trays. We like our cheese trays. And we definitely like our wine. So some of the girls will bring bottles of wine. Some will bring food and this kind of thing. And we just kind of spread it out on a table. We go in and put our pajamas on after we've had about two glasses of wine, because then we know the excitement's getting ready to start the fun part. And this is fabulous, because what we usually do, is that we have like a movie night. Now, we got our pajamas on. We're probably wearing our mask by that time and have done our skincare. And we're stuffing our face. And we're chilling. We're waiting for the movie of the night. Now, we always pick movies that are highly, highly emotional and romantic. And generally, they're back kind of in the 60s. Now, just to give you a for instance. Well, now, don't get me wrong. We like The Notebook. Because, see, we want it emotional so we can all cry together, because that's just fun. You know, nothing better than a sad, heart-touching movie. Okay, so we'll watch movies like Sayonara. It's way back when. If you haven't seen it, you got to do it. We watch movies like Picnic. We watch movies like Splendor in the Grass. You know, all these different older movies, like A Summer Place, Peyton Place. We go on back. I have a huge collection of old movies way back when. I even have movies like Palm Springs Weekend and all this kind of stuff that was so much fun. But we love all these movies. So we're drinking our wine. We're chit-chatting. We're loving our movies. We're masking. We're doing our thing. Sometimes we're, you know, massaging each other's feet. Sometimes we're, you know, giving each other pedicures. It doesn't matter. We're together. We're having a blast. And that's our night. To spend the night just like a normal slumber party. Yes, we have a blast. And that really, really seals a close relationship between women. We need our time where we're away from men, we're away from work, and we can talk. We can talk about the private things we have on our minds. If we have some issues and we need feedback, we can talk to our girlfriends about it, and they can usually solve your problem just like that, because it's an outsider looking in. Do you see what I'm saying? Sometimes we get so caught up in stuff, we don't know our from a hole in the ground, if you know what I mean. But to bounce it off our girlfriends, oh my gosh, hello! Nothing better, and the advice you get is remarkable. And especially advice about men. Now, some of us are single, some of us are divorced, some of us are married in the group. But we're always together. And sometimes on our slumber party nights, we might go to what we call the King's Spy. Now here in Dallas, this place is huge. It's got big lions out front, you know. And I mean, not real lions, you know, I'm talking about the architecture of the place. And it's, you know, all kinds of foreign stuff, like way back when. I know that sounds stupid. It's because I'm thinking I'm going to show you pictures around here so you can kind of see what it is. But you pay a certain price. You can go in and get massage. You can get pedicures. You can be in the great big pools of all different shapes and sizes. And the bar is actually sitting in the water, and we can just float up to it and have a drink as well. If we like to spend the night there, they do have a section that is the hotel part, and we can all crash together there. But there are exercise machines there. There's steam rooms there. There's everything you could possibly imagine, and I'm going to show you how posh it is. And it's not that expensive. You spend one set price, okay, as you walk in, and it's not that expensive to do all of this. As a matter of fact, we all have memberships because we like to go frequently and just chill. And so it's even cheaper when we buy a membership that covers the whole year. But back to the story. I'm giving you ideas is what I'm doing, ladies, okay? And there's nothing like all of us just, you know, laid out and getting massages together, and we can chat and talk. You know, we're getting mud masks. We're getting whatever we want, but we are together. And then what is fun, and you all ask me all the different things we do. Lots of things that we do are fun. Sometimes we go and we rent a trolley for the night because we all pitch in. And you can get these trolleys that'll take us downtown and through the uptown area, which is the partying area. And we can just, you know, watch everybody have fun, or we can stop and get out and have a glass of wine and have fun with the rest of them and jump back on. There's music and everything on here. Sometimes we get wound up and we just sing our heart away as we're on these little trolleys, hanging our head out the window, just waving, and, you know, we're skunked. But we are having a blast. And the thing about it is, it's the quality time that you have with your girlfriends that is so, so important for your character. It's not only character building, but emotionally, you need your girlfriends around you. You got to have them. And a lot of people say, Sharon, it's been so hard for us to find good girlfriends. Oh, no. They're everywhere. I mean, when we go out, we even collect more. People are just drawn to us because we're so crazy about each other. We hug and we love each other so much, and we're having fun. We're doing our thing. We're not getting into any trouble. But it's the talking. It's the camaraderie. It's the we can crown each other's shoulder. We can laugh. We can gossip. We can do whatever we want to do, but we are together. And that is the most important thing. And it's fun to travel. We have traveled together. We've been to Cabo together. We've been to Cancun. You know, we've been to Puerto Rico. We've been to St. Martin's, all these different places. But you can take your girlfriends and you all can just have a blast. And it's so important that we have that in our life. And it's funny how I find so many women that are catty with each other, or jealous of each other, or something like that. And that's not the way life's supposed to be. You know, you all ask me about this, and you know what? Y'all just can't believe how long we've been doing this. We've been doing this forever and ever. I mean, for years and years and years and years. We've been through, a couple of my divorces, and we were doing it before that, and on. But the thing about it is that we hang close with each other. Do you know what I'm saying? We tell each other all our deepest, darkest secrets, and whatever's bothering us, you know, they all jump in there. Oh, let me tell you what to do about this, or let me tell you how to think, or blah, blah, blah. And that's where we all come in together. We love each other, so we nurture each other and take care of each other. We're not jealous of each other. If anything, we build each other up. Every month when we get together for our usually our one night gig, I mean, it's You have no idea what it does for your self-esteem. You have no idea how it calms you down. It helps you get rid of anxiety, believe it or not. And my girlfriends and I, we even meditate together. We've gone to spas where we do a lot of meditation, and we do things like that. We do everything. You just name it, and the more outrageous it is, the better. So I want you gals to really get with your gal pals, as they call them, and think of something fun you can do together every single week. And maybe it's going out and having lunch. We do that too. We do lunch. We generally do dinners, this kind of thing. But at least we're all together. We can cut up. We can talk to each other. We can be there for one another. This is going to help you so much with your relationships with other women. Because believe it or not, we're all exactly the same. We all have issues. We're all emotional. We're all sensitive. And what's really fun is now that we are all, the majority of us, I think there's one of us left that hadn't finished her menopause, so she's still going through some stuff. But the rest of us, we're postmenopausal, but because we are, we can help her through the rest of hers. And we've been there for each other through all of this. Every time we, you know, want to get crabby, every time we had a hot flash, every time we were, you know, listen to our kids argue or fight, or there's a problem in the family, whatever it is, whether it was work-related, it doesn't matter. We talk to each other, and it's like, it all goes away. And that's why you need the women in your life, the ones you really trust and you really love. These women have been in my life for eons and eons and eons. We've gone through divorces together, having kids, you know, popping out around the same time or so. Our kids doing this, our kids doing that. One mess after another, but we've always been there for each other. And this is what is important. And I always tell you women, you're not whole. You're not a whole person unless you really understand and have close girlfriends. You must have that. You know, you can't separate yourself from your friends. This is what is going to keep you young and thriving and going places and have a blast. Okay? I wanted to share that with you. I know you've asked me a million times to go over that with you, but yes, we have done everything. I mean, we've been in hot air balloons together. We've been places you don't even want to know together. We do the craziest things. And you know, we'll try anything at least once. Trust me. So we get out there and we just sit and think of things. But just to give you a for instance, I'm going to insert a couple of things down below that, you know, we have done. And I'm going to show you some pictures of different places we go. This will give you ideas too. And remember, even if you're having the greatest movie night and your mask is all and you all are sitting there and you're whiffing down your coffee, your tea, your wine, whatever you've got going and munching out on the groceries, you're together and you're having a blast. But it is so much fun. And we just crash wherever we can afterwards. It is so fun. So, I love each and every one of you. Thank you so much for requesting this. I do like to talk about my girlfriends because that's my heart and soul. Trust me, they really are. I would do anything in the world for them and vice versa. So, I do like talking about it. Thank you so very much. And to each and every one of you new subbies that have joined me, mwah, 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 mwah. I just love you girls. Thank you so much. I hope you're enjoying my channel. I love you. And to every single one of you, I want you to stay sassy, classy, and confident. And give me a big thumbs up on this video.